How does civil asset forfeiture work? First, let's explain criminal asset forfeiture. In a criminal asset forfeiture, law enforcement arrests and charges an individual with a crime. During this encounter, property such as cash or a vehicle that may have been used as part of the criminal activity is confiscated. And if the individual is later convicted of a crime, that property is forfeited and given to the government. It seems pretty straightforward, but the confusion comes into play with civil asset forfeiture. With civil asset forfeiture, the individual does not need to be convicted of a crime. But instead, a case is filed in court against the property itself. Oftentimes, this is because there isn't enough evidence to actually convict the person of a crime. Since this legal process is easier, it creates an incentive for prosecutors to pursue a civil asset forfeiture rather than a criminal one. Why is this a problem? Civil asset forfeiture leaves certain doors open for potential abuse and the violation of people's rights. A system such as this funnels both guilty and innocent people into having their property taken. It's extremely difficult for an innocent person to fight and receive the full value of their cash or property back. And while a person may not be convicted of a crime, it is much easier for a prosecutor to produce weak evidence that an individual's property was involved in a crime. This creates a system that is ripe for abuse. It's tantamount to legalized theft. That's the problem in a nutshell. We're Libertas Institute, and we're working to put a stop to this practice, because people and their property should be presumed innocent until they're convicted of a crime.